Hello everyone. Today we have with us Professor Ganesh, Head Sociology Department, Osmania University. We welcome you, sir, to the Department of Communication and Journalism.
Thank you.
Sir, what are the courses offered in Sociology in Osmania University?
In Osmania University, we are offering MA Sociology at postgraduate level and also MPhil and PhD programs. Apart from the campus college, we are also offering two courses at our constituent colleges. One is at Nizam College and another one at OU College for Women at Koti. At Nizam College, we are offering BA Sociology as well as MA Sociology, and at Koti Women's College, we are offering BA Sociology, and along with that, we are also offering one PG diploma in Family and Marriage Counseling. So these are the courses offered by Department of Sociology, Osmania University.
So what is the eligible criteria for this course to enter into?
Yeah, to enter into PG program in Sociology, any student who has completed a graduate course are eligible to take admission into MA Sociology.
Sir, what after completion of the course, what are the career opportunities?
Yeah, in fact, Sociology is the science of society. In fact, it focuses on the study of various social issues and various development programs initiated by the government of India and also respective state governments. So, once the student complete MA Sociology, they have wider opportunities both in government sector as well as private sector. And as far as a government sector is concerned, they can be absorbed in national and state level research institutions. For example, in the case of Andhra Pradesh and Telangana states, we have research institutes like National Institute of Rural Development at Rajendra Nagar, where many sociology students have an opportunity to work there as assistant directors or research associates or research officers. Similarly, we have another institute called NIN, National Institute of Nutrition, where sociology candidates are absorbed there. So like that, there are many government institutions, basically they are research institutions where sociology students are absorbed there. And apart from that, there are many non-governmental organizations in private sector, and especially there are many international and national level organizations like ActionAid or UNICEF or World Health Organization. Likewise, there are many international organizations where the sociology students are absorbed in various research activities. And apart from that, there are many non-governmental organizations which were funded by the state government and government of India, and sometimes some of the NGOs get their funds from international organizations. So in those organizations also, there are many employment opportunities for sociology students. But one thing I would like to say here is that to get an employment, whether in state-sponsored research institutions or the non-governmental organizations, students are supposed to have certain skills, especially the research skills. Why? Because most of the sociology students will get an employment opportunity in the research field only. So therefore, they must have good research skills. So they must have command over certain subjects like research methodology, then social statistics, then report writing skills. Then apart from that, they must have thorough knowledge in certain specialized subjects. because sociology offers different specializations like rural sociology and rural development, urban sociology and urban development, criminology, industrial sociology, then sociology of health. Likewise, there are many specializations. So, if the student have an in-depth knowledge in all these specializations, there are ample opportunities to get an employment, whether in government sector or in non-governmental organizations.
Sir, any suggestions to students regarding the course?
In fact, sociology is considered as one of the best subjects. Why I am saying this? Number one, if a student would like to join in government service nowadays, they can appear for civil services examination with sociology as one of the optional. Why? Because now at national level, large number of students are opting sociology as one of the optional to appear for civil services examination, so that they can enter into government service, especially All India services. And apart from that, with the sociological knowledge, they can also appear for the state level examinations conducted by like Andhra Pradesh Public Service Commission or the Telangana State Public Service Commission. So, this is with regard to the government services. But apart from that, if they have good research skills, they can enter into any national or international organizations. Okay. So, they can get very good employment opportunities in such institutions which I have mentioned so far. So, therefore, ultimately it depends upon the academic and research caliber of a student to get an employment. Ultimately, the student tries to get some employment after the completion of their academic qualifications. So, as far as sociology is concerned, if they are good at subject, definitely they have very good employment opportunities. But they have to take it very serious.
Sir, do sociology students face any competition from the MSW students?
Sociology and social work, these two subjects, they go together. Generally, sociology is considered as a pure science, where its focus is more on theoretical knowledge. But apart from that, we also have practicals, where student is trained in conducting research, by using different tools or techniques. They are supposed to collect the data from the communities, from the society, and on the basis of that data, they are supposed to write research reports. And same thing can be seen even in social work. Basically, social work is an applied science. That means sociology is a pure science, whereas social work is an applied science, where the focus of social work is more on field work rather than on theory. Yes, nowadays for sociology students, there is a lot of competition from social work. Why? Because nowadays some of the NGOs are preferring social work students only, especially to work with the rural and tribal communities. But in spite of this competition, still there are many opportunities. Why? Because in sociology, we train the students not only in research methodology, but also in sociological theory. So, that is why most of the sociology students have a strong theoretical base apart from the knowledge in methodology. But whereas in case of social work students, they are very good at field work, but generally they do not have the strong theoretical base. That is why, depending upon the nature of work in different organizations, sometimes they prefer sociology candidates rather than the social work candidates. But on the whole, both sociology and social work students have very good opportunities, but provided, again and again I am telling, provided if they have good research skills and very good report writing skills. These two are very important to get an employment in the job market. Right.
Okay, sir. Thank you so much, sir.